I am in your presence. Fill me with your power.
I would like to share a little things from the book of Revelation. You have your Bible, your spiritual weapon. You must carry the Bible, okay? Jesus is in it, you are in it, and I'm in it, okay? There is the book of books. The reason that we make mistakes sometimes and sins, because we don't know the Word of God. I'm not talking that, you know, God is going to send us to the hell. He don't make the hell for human beings. But unfortunately, some, when they reject Jesus, you know, they go another way. So keep your Bible with you, because you want to meet Jesus in His Word.
Amen.
You want to meet Jesus, go in His Word. That's it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Chapter 3, verse 7.
Revelation 3, 7. And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these things saith he that is holy, he that is true, he that had the keys of David, and he that openeth, and no man shutteth, and shutteth, and no man openeth. I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it. For thou hast a little strength, and hast kept my word, and hast not denied my name. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say that they are Jews, but are not, but do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet, and to know that I have loved thee, because thou hast kept my words of my patience, and will also keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world, and try them that dwell upon the earth. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. Him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God.
Amen.
And he shall go no more out. And I will write upon him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my God. And I will write upon him my new name. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the church.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And Jesus, you know, visit the pastor of this church. He say, you know, and to my angel in the city of Philadelphia. Angel is the pastor, the messenger who has good news for you, that I did today. What is the good news? That Jesus is on his throne, that's it, and has the control from everything.
Amen.
So don't bother about what you see, what you read, how is your circumstances around you. You understand me?
Amen.
Jesus is alive. That's the great news. That's what we proclaim here. So, seven churches represent seven different periods of our life. It's not the time now to explain all of that stuff. It was a Greek area. Now it's under Islamic captivity, this area, the seven churches. And the Lord, you know, visit the pastor. I want to tell you something. Nobody else upon the pastor in the church. And I don't agree when the pastor has other office, and the office tell you do that, do that, do that. Because a pastor, a bishop, or a bishop is a person who appointed by God and planted by God in the church. And nobody else can move except Jesus.
Amen.
You see, sometimes there are many churches says, oh, I'm pastor, I'm assistant pastor, and another assistant, and a pastor from the kids, and the pastor from the elders, and pastor from disability, and pastor from barbecue, and pastor from celebration, from birthday, so many pastors. I met somebody who tells me, we are sorry pastors. Sorry pastors. And I told him, I'm sorry. If God visits this church today, who is the pastor that has to apologize of the mistakes of the church? Because pastor is a person who has to apologize when somebody, you know, suffered with no reason, somebody abused it. Pastor is a person, is a problem solver.
That's right.
You understand me? Is a person with anointing who can touch others to bring healing and deliverance. Amen. Pastor, in the last days, without healing and deliverance, yeah, is not a pastor. Yeah. Maybe it's a preacher or butcher or anything else, but not pastor. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pastor is somebody who has love, who has compassion in his heart, okay? Who is not stingy?
Amen.
One knows that the members suffer, you know? He's gonna say, I'm gonna pray for you. Don't allow any pastor to pray about your finances if you don't take his wallet to give you $100. Years back, somebody tells me, you know, I'm gonna pray for you. Young pastor, he tells me, young pastor, I'm gonna pray for you. I say, okay, but love is action.
Yeah.
You understand me?
Amen.
I can pray for myself.
Yes.
Why I need mediator?
Right.
Jesus is my mediator.
Amen.
You understand me? I went one day, I adopted that behavior when I was young. And I went to the church and a couple don't have, you know, the rent. And the Lord tells me, give it $500. All your wallet. I started to rebuke my ears. I think was the voice of Satan to destroy my finances. This comes again, the voice. You tell me, give to this couple, needs you the money. I still rejected. The third time, the voice was very corrected and directly in my ear. You wanna give it, or I will find it somebody else to take that salary. I give it. I check it, and I did. I obey.
Amen.
But listen, Jesus, it's so beautiful. Eh? After the service, comes a woman. He say, are you John Zavlaris? I say, yes, it's me. I have a message from the Lord. I said, I'm ready. I love messages. I said, what is the message? He tells me, put that money in the envelope and give it to that person. I opened after, and it was the same money that I give to the couple.
Oh,
amen. I was a surprise. So after that, you know, action, you know, I receive. That's the pastor. I'm talking about pastor, you know, because if pastor is not the head of the church and so many, where are you going to go to talk?
Yes.
Pastor has to be available in your problem,
yes,
not to give you appointed. Like you go October and December 9, they give you appointed. But this sickness can kill you.
Yes.
You understand me? It happened to somebody. He gives appointment to the woman who was sick, and the sick woman passed away next week. He gives after 3 months appointment. And he say, what is this woman? The elder says he passed away. Waiting, you know, in the room for your invitation. That's because Jesus, you know, accepts you all the days, all the time, day and night, 3 o'clock, is not a human being. That's called. You know his number? That's Holy Spirit. Connected. You understand? That's because be wired with Jesus. Okay? Sometimes we are Christians, but we look like a laptop. What's the big deal if you have a nice laptop, Apple? No internet inside. What are you going to do? You can go nowhere. But with internet, you can see in 5 minutes all the news of the world. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Included, you see our videos here, what's going on every Sunday here, beautiful things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he said to my angel, in the church of Philadelphia, I want to tell you something. This is the best church. The Greek word is Philadelphia, the Greek word means friend and brother. Two words. Philos means friend, Adelphos means brother. Friend and brother together means Philadelphia. This is the church of Rapture. And this is the exactly pastor who the Holy Spirit, you know, like it. You understand me? So he visited him. He visited all of them actually, but not all of them was ready, okay? So he said to him, okay, that say the holy, okay, the true, who has the key of David? Hallelujah.
Amen.
You try to unlock many situations with the wrong key, but you, if you don't have the key of God in your life, you can go nowhere. Always the door shall be closed. Mm-hmm. Do you understand me?
Yeah.
Like, for every situation there is a key.
Amen.
I remember a preacher went to Islamic country and tried to go into the Islamic country to preach the gospel. But they broke him 2 days. So the preacher says, Lord, what's going on? He say, you left in the United States one person who has the key to unlock the burden.
Oh.
So call him. He called him. After 2 days, he came there. And when he takes the passport for 150 people, in 10 minutes, everybody, they goes in. That's, I explain you what is the key. You have to find the exactly person, including for your deliverance, for your restoration. You have to find it, you know, the exactly person who has the call to deliver people. No, who say in the name of Jesus. Well, everybody say in the name of Jesus. And nothing happens.
Amen.
Be healed! Be healed! I say to somebody, don't scream like this. Be healed, be healed. You see that you don't move. Right? It's like a wood. You don't move. Better silent, you know. Hallelujah. So he say, you know, the key. Who opened on this close? I'm going to tell you something. When God sent you somewhere, he provides and protects.
Amen.
That's it. Maybe you want to go to Nigeria, you want to go to another country. It's nice. But don't use your credit card to go there. You have to pay after, you know, double price. If God sent you, he's provide and protect. The last week here, we have a message. It came to a woman, very, he received deliverance. For 2 months, he was very happy. Then, after 2 months, for some reason, he lost and he don't came back. He goes to another ministry, praise God, and nothing happened. He came back, you know, and testified that I went there without application and now I'm very sick. Mm-hmm. And now I tell her, did you use your credit card? She say, yes. You go there without God's guidance. You pay $5,000 without healing, nothing. And you must pay now with interest every month. Listen. Wisdom. Okay? Just waiting until God move you.
Yes.
Until God direct you.
Amen.
Do you understand me?
Amen.
I'm very difficult now and very serious. When I have to do something, I must ask the Lord.
Yes.
If the Lord don't say nothing, because in any situation that you find yourself in, Jesus has to say something.
Yep. Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
If Jesus don't talk, wait.
Wait.
Amen.
I'm gonna marriage him. Which so looks nice. His wallet is good.
That's true.
Okay, I said to her, one day marriage him. After a year, I said, Pastor, I'm possessed. You are possessed because your eyes look upon him.
Right.
How big is, how his arm is, how tall is, but you don't see that he has spiritual wife. And when you go to sleep, you're going to have one woman, the original, and the fake woman next side. Three people. Wow. And when you was possessed, you don't have, you know, desire for the original person. So if you feel desire from your partner, means you're in good way. You know? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beautiful. He say, okay, you open the door, okay? Okay, he says, I know your work, but I open the door for you. That's beautiful. If God opened the door, go through.
Amen.
When God guides you to do, go, to be afraid.
Amen.
Don't you think you know something, just go.
Amen.
Okay, and he say, here, door, very, very open door. But he say, you have a small power, you see? He says, he feels like it's nothing. You know, when you are a humble person, you don't feel like something embarrassing. And I feel like comfortable. They tell me sometimes, you know, and they go, oh, Reverend, you're welcome. I say to somebody, I'm not Holy Spirit. I'm not just John. Take a little John from Greece. That's what you're looking for. You understand me? He says, you know, you have a small, but the most important, he says, you cares for my word, and you keep in your heart my word. That's very important. The Holy Spirit wants to know, you know, what is the position of your heart? In what level is your faith?
Oh.
Don't worry about your sugar, diabetes, and you check all the time. Check your faith. In what level is, if you want to get the results, eh?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay. But you take care of my hand, and you never you deny. Listen, look at what say here. Never you deny my name. Sometimes, you know, people get deliverance here, and I say to them, you know, okay, give us your testimony. No, that's later, another time. I'm afraid. But they want blessings. That's the secret, okay? But Jesus says you never deny. Means we have to be, listen, Jesus is yesterday, today, and forever the same, okay? We have to be the same people. If you like me, you don't have to be copy for me. Be copy of Jesus.
Yes.
Do you understand me?
Yes.
So when you are a copy of Jesus, you know, you will become one. Because he say, where I am, over there shall be my servant. That's it. So he says here to the men of Philadelphia, here, to the pastor, okay, you never deny my name. But he informed him, there is another church, another synagogue, okay, another gathering, okay, who they say are Christian, but they're not. Because Satan overruled in this church. But I'm going to make them to come to realize that you are my servant.
Amen.
I want to tell you something. Don't try to introduce yourself. Don't try to expose to others who are you. God is going to come one day to exalt from of the Father's throne. He's going to say, okay, my father, this is my daughter from Sierra Leone. This is John from Greece. Eh? This is, you know, George from South Africa. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then all the glory shall become upon us.
Amen.
Do you understand me?
Amen.
We don't need nothing. Just we need his presence in our life. He said here, you know, there is a group of Satan. And in the last days you will see a lot of stuff negative on TV. Because they will be hiding the money.
Wow.
And you go to buy through the, soon you will see. With cards, after the cards, you know what's going on, okay? And then, after that, they will betray the new world order. I'm not afraid to say the truth. The new world order already works. They try to give a new name of religion. All these big bishops around the world shall be reunited today by one spirit, you know what kind of spirit, and they give a new name to the church. The only they have problem, according to Thessalonians 2nd chapter, okay, that says that the problem is the Holy Spirit. The problem is they want to prepare a religion. They want churches, they want pastors without Jesus, Holy Bible, and you. That's it. They don't like. They don't like spirit who says the truth. No. They will discover a new religion. Don't go with them. Yeah. Stay with Jesus. Amen. Okay? He's going to reveal this. He said to the pastor, you know, there is some of them around you, but they come to worship you. I put them kneeling. You understand me?
Amen.
10 verses says, because you keep my word, your love, you keep the Bible up, and the truth, he says here, you know, because you do that, I'm going to take care of you in the day of turmoil, in the day of affliction, in the day of the dark day. You remember when people go to Jesus to arrest him, Jesus says, this is the day of the darkness.
Amen.
Okay? Okay, take me. You look for me, I'm Jesus. Leave it, Peter. And John and James, you look for me, take me. This is the day of the darkness. Don't be afraid of the day of the darkness. Mm-hmm. Say all the time, you go to your house, let there be light. Huh? Yeah. Let there be light. Deny to accept, you know, sickness. Say, you know, I'm a healthy person fighting sickness. Don't say, I have that, I have that. Yes, you can say sometimes, but, you know, really, you know, deny to say, because, you know, sickness cannot bother you, cannot send you out of the will of God.
Amen.
You can be a sick, but you can be a child of the living God.
Amen.
You can be a poor, but you can be a child of the living God,
Amen.
A friend of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he says to the pastor here, I'm gonna take care of you, don't worry. Because I was in love with you. You understand me? So he say, I'm gonna take care of you because it's coming worldwide, you know, a problems for all those who they're dwelling on the face of the earth. All. There are some churches in the United States, they open holes and put food. That's stupid thing. If Jesus don't take care of you, you understand me? Where you go? In, out, the spirit. Spiritual can find you wherever you go. But when you live by the Spirit of God, who can touch you? If there is upon your life the seal of the living God, who can touch you? You see here sometimes say, don't look at me. Don't touch on me. Why? Yeah. Spiritually is the explanation. Okay? You say here, the 11, I'm coming soon. Keep it that you have from me, that I have given to you. Okay? Because nobody else can steal your crown from your head. But you don't see crown right now. Huh? You see crown in me?
No.
No?
No.
No crown? Spiritually you have crown.
Amen.
You know, you are prince.
Amen.
You're a child of the Most High God.
Amen.
Do you understand me? Spiritually, you know, the book of Revelation chapter 1 says he makes us priests and kings.
Amen.
That's it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He say here, you know, who got victory, I'm going to make it him, Pilate, in the temple of my God.
Wow.
Hallelujah. He say, and when I write, you know, the new name, you know, and the name of the new city, he replies it, Jesus, everything. What the Old Testament says, he makes the new. He makes the Jerusalem, now the Jewish, after time, they want to break down the temple of the Muslim temple. And they rebuilt very quickly because they have all the equipment. They rebuilt the temple. When you see that, you know, the three worldwide war started already. Soon you will see that. All right? And you say here, I'm gonna make you a pilot, and you know, in the temple of my God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I feel now, you know, his presence, you know, touching me.
Amen.
If I feel good with you here on the Grand Plaza Hotel, okay, what about in this presence when we go?
Amen.
With all those people who they go with the Lord. I miss to see my father who goes with the Lord. I miss my wife. What? I want to see all of them. What a beautiful time, eh?
Amen.
To stay in his temple.
Amen.
And he says here, okay, when I write his name, I don't know, I like it, John. But I have strong desire to see what is my eternal name. Wow. Everybody has name. Huh? They are ministers sometimes, but when somebody introduces, he tells us here is the reverend, prophet, three names, owner of that, and builder, and senior pastor. But he said, I'm going to give you only one name.
Amen.
And God is going to know that name.
Amen.
Jesus is going to know you. And I'm going to tell you something. Automatically, by his spirit, okay, there will be know you all those who they go with the Lord and they walk with the Lord. That's forever.
Amen.
I love eternal life.
Amen.
I love eternal life. I'm going to tell you something. When I accept Jesus, I was 28 years old man. But I was telling him, enough is enough that I live in that hell. I want to escape. I want something beautiful. Because the Holy Bible don't lie. Huh? Some religion says, if you go there and you eat rice and honey and do that. And, No, that don't say the Bible that. You understand me? The Bible says if you know Jesus and knows you, and your name is in the book, in this book, the book of life, you go there, you meet him, you'll enjoy forever. Huh? I cook one day and somebody the fire touching me, oof, I burned my finger. I say, what about Jesus if you don't save me? How I go to the hell? You know, 3,000 degree over there.
Mm.
I don't like it, but I like with you.
Amen.
Music, nice.
Amen.
Are you lonesome, Almighty? Holy is the Lamb. Eh? Holy is the Lamb. Ah, well, beautiful, eh? Some worship, you know? Some worship comes from the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
I like it. I don't understand why people go in so many clubs here all the night, the clubs, and they dancing like Mike Jackson. It is Greek to me. How do you do that? Symbol. Lift your hand. That the Bible says, lift your eyes, lift your faith, and start worship. By His anointing. And He's going to answer you soon.
Amen.
That's it. So, and the last verse says, who has ear? I'm going to tell you something. Are you sure that your ear is in a good place? Yeah, touch your ear. Touch it with me. Your left first. Your right ear, it's over there. Let's pray for your ear to learn to listen the voice of Jesus Christ. That's very important. It was many, there are deaf outside. Huh? Born again people is somebody who his ear is very sensitive, okay? Because we must listen the word from the heaven, okay? Be ready, you know? Another word says to the revelation, the bride, okay? The bride says, come Lord. Somebody tells me, when Jesus comes? I says, how you know that? Okay, you shall know when you go to your church and everybody pray, come Jesus, enough. Now I said to somebody, if you go to your church, everybody say, come Lord. I don't hear somebody to say, come Lord. Everybody say, I need a car, I need a new car. I need finance, I need a Greek card, I need that Lord. You know, what I try to tell you, open your spiritual ear. Amen. In His voice, and close all this negative voice who say that, who say that, who say that. You can't find it, the good opinion, in internet.
Amen.
Like, you go to Google. Okay, there are good and bad. Chosen the good thing. If you put one name, you will see all the negative. If you believe, you lost the blessings. Ask the Holy Spirit as Christians. Is Mary, is George, is John a good person, Lord? Can I connect with him? And always looking for good connection. Separate yourself for those who they don't bless you, criticize you, critical. Brought you outside of the will of God. Oh, come in my house, you know, today Yankees play. Mm. And we drink some couple of beers. And couple of beers, after that game, 4 hours, can you say hallelujah?
No.
Tell me.
No.
Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Amen.